Now we're going to move on and make you experts when it comes to slicing and dicing matrix vector multiplication. A very important way of partitioning a matrix is this 3x3 partitioning that you've already seen when you implemented some of the manipulation of special matrices. What do we have here? We have a 3x3 partitioning of our matrix. On the right, we have a concrete example. And these lines here tell us how the matrix on the right is partitioned. Of course, this is just an example. A00 is a submatrix, and notice that it's a 2x2 matrix. And notice that we use an uppercase letter because it's a matrix. To its right is a vector because it's part of a column, and so forth. Notice that the middle element here is just a scalar, so we use a Greek lowercase letter. And to its left and right are parts of the row. And therefore we use a lowercase letter and this transpose to indicate that it's a row vector. Similarly, we can go and partition a vector x. And here we're partitioning it into a subvector, that's the first two elements, a scalar, that's the middle element, and a subvector, that's the rest of the elements. And we're going to look at y is equal to a times x, and we're going to partition our vector y similarly. Let's look at what we will call a partitioned matrix vector multiplication. If we multiply this out, the first subvector of y is computed as this times that plus this times that, plus this times that, which is written right here. Okay. Notice that that's exactly the dot product of a row with a vector that we saw if these were just scalars or actual values, except that we're now doing it with symbols. And one thing that's very important is that while scalar multiplication commutes, that's not the case when you do a matrix times a vector. Similarly, this middle element of y is computed as this times that plus this times that plus this times that. And we recognize that as a dot product, a scalar multiplication, and another dot product. This final subvector of y is computed as this times that plus this times that plus this times that. This right here. And notice that it's, again, very important to notice that all we're doing is the same thing as we would do if we had actual values sitting there. We just happen to be doing it with symbols. Okay, so if we now take a concrete example and we look at how to compute the matrix vector multiplication with the formula that we just showed, what you notice is that A00 is this block right here, so it's that. And then you have to multiply that times x0, which is this subvector right here, which is right there, and so forth. So all you do is you substitute in what the different parts of the matrix are and what the different parts of the vector are. Pay attention to the red elements here. If we take this expression right here, we know how to do this matrix vector multiplication and this vector times a scalar, etc. So we repeat what we just had right here. And if we multiply all of that out, so for example, if you multiply this times that, we get this subvector right here. And if we multiply this times that, then we get this subvector right here, etc. And if now, what do we get? We get these vectors that all need to be added together, and the same thing in the other parts of this vector. So again, we repeat the last result from the previous page here, and if we now go and we actually add these vectors together, what we get is this right here. And the important thing is that if you carefully look at the elements that were in red, you see that we're doing exactly the same dot product here that we did to compute an element of y by doing a dot product of a row of a with the vector x. So here we repeat this last result from the previous page again, and if you look very carefully, that's just this matrix vector multiplication. It's this times that plus this times that, etc., which is what starts showing up right here. Okay, so as a general rule, when you partition the matrix and you partition the vectors, and you do so conformally, which means that the sizes need to correspond. That's what this all here says. Then when you do a matrix vector multiplication, you do it exactly as you were taught how to do a matrix vector multiplication before, except you do it with symbols. In other words, a typical ith part of the vector y, the ith subvector of y, is just computed by taking the inner product of the corresponding row of A with the vector x partitioned into the submatrices and subvectors. Okay, look carefully at this, and then look carefully at what happens when you do a regular matrix vector multiplication. If you go back and forth, here we do it with scalars. Here we do it with the submatrices and subvectors. It's one and the same thing. Partitioned matrix times a partitioned vector multiplication is exactly the same as a regular matrix vector multiplication with scalars, except that the scalars become symbols or submatrices. And it's very important that multiplication with these symbols doesn't always commute. For scalar multiplication, you can do 3 times 2, which is the same as 2 times 3. But it's not the case in general that a matrix times a vector is the same as a vector times a matrix. Again, this is not even defined.